my limit. Niggas. Nigga.
Hi, Aries. This is a reading for Aries for April 2021. Thank you so much for coming to my channel to watch this reading. Please make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and hit the ring-a-ding, ding, ding, dingy bell so you can catch all my latest content and all the readings that I have for each zodiac sign, okay? So let's get straight into it. I already shuffled the deck, cut the cards, meditated, and at the bottom of the deck we have the High Priestess. She who knows. She who knows. Okay, Aries, this could be you or somebody you're dealing with who's very intuitive. There is some abundance behind the veil because the pomegranates represent abundance. Or there's some secrets, some hidden information not yet known. Something hidden. Something hidden. Or Aries, your spirit guides is telling you that you are connected. You are connected to your spirit guides. So let's see. You could be listening to your intuition about something. We have the Fool. This is you, Aries. You could be dealing with a Leo or Sagittarius. This is a new beginning. Taking a leap of faith. Sight unseen. Going into the unknown. Not knowing what's waiting on the other side. Trusting your intuition on this new spiritual path. This new spiritual journey. This new beginning here. Somebody's going back and forth about a decision or taking this leap of faith. Maybe somebody's weighing up the pros and the cons about some type of new beginning. Aries, you have the Moon. Could be dealing with a Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio. But the Moon represents secrets. Confusion, fear, cheating, or being left in the dark about some things. Some things not yet known. Something that is hidden. There could be some secrets here, okay? Three of Cups, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. This is we are reunited and it feels so good. Let's go out. Drink, party, eat, and be merry. Oh, this is some type of reconciliation happening between you and your person. We have Strength. This is you, Aries, Leo, or Sag. You could be dealing with the Leo or Sagittarius. You're trying to tame your lust, restricting yourself from something, holding yourself back from something. Let's see. We're going to see what this is all about. Clarify the Fool for Aries. Clarify the Fool for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus for April 2021. Ancestors, spirit guides, universal energies. Clarify the Fool for Aries in love. Clarify the Fool for Aries in love. For April 2021. Clarify the Fool. The Four of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Someone holding on. Or keeping something close to their chest. Someone protecting their pentacles. Saving money. A miser. A penny pincher. Or someone keeping a secret. Now, with the Fool and the Four of Pentacles, this could be a new beginning that someone was keeping a secret. Or someone is going into the unknown and they're saving up some money here for this new journey that they're about to take. Someone is keeping something close to their chest. We're going to find out. Once all the cards are laid down, we'll have a better storyline. Why is the Two of Pentacles here? Clarify the Two of Pentacles for Aries. For the fire sign of Aries for the month of April 2021. Clarify the Two of Pentacles. Spirit guides. Thank you, Spirit. You don't know with the Two of Pentacles about something. Someone's juggling something, but the Ace of Wands is here. Something, this may be a new passionate beginning. This may be something that you're very creative about. Something, a new passionate beginning, or something you're very creative about, you're very passionate about. It has a lot of potential for growth. You could be weighing up the pros and the cons if you want to start a new passionate beginning with someone here. It could be a Leo, okay, with the Ace of Wands, or this is you, or someone you're dealing with. I could say, clarify the Moon. Oh, that flew out quick. Yeah, there's like some secrets here, some fear. Being in the dark about some things, being all up in your feelings about some things, and there's like little to no communication. Nothing's really happening right now. Nothing's really moving right now, okay? Because something is hidden. Something is unknown. Something is a secret, or someone cheated and they're not really, you know, saying anything about it. It's like little to no communication. Whatever this is, we'll figure this out. Look at this Seven of Swords. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, you could be dealing with this person. Someone is trying to escape, lying, cheating. Someone's a thief. Someone's deceptive, strategizing a plan of action, or trying to get away with something, trying to escape. Why is the Three of Cups here? Yeah, someone wants to reconcile. Or this is like you going out with friends and family to celebrate something. Celebrate a new beginning. A new journey. You're trusting your intuition to take you to this new journey, sight unseen. You're just going off into the wind and you're just doing it. Or someone wants to reconcile. They want a new beginning with you. They want to take a leap of faith. Go off into the wind and just do it. Just reconcile, eat, drink, and be married. Reunite. Somebody wants to get back together, maybe. They want a new beginning with you. Or like I said, you're celebrating something new here. Celebrating a new beginning, Two of Cups. This could be a soul tie. You're attracted to someone here, Aries, or someone is attracted to you. This could be a Leo or a Cancer because of this lady here. Okay? I feel like this could be like a friend, a co-worker, or someone you could be married to, or just have like a strong soulmate connection. Maybe this is also you wanting to meet up, hook up, link up with a friend, spend time with them, something like that. Okay, why is the Strength here? Why is the Strength card here? Clarify Strength for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, North Node. Clarify Strength for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Spirit guides, angels, ancestors, universal energies. Clarify Strength for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Six of Swords. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. You could be dealing with this person, or this is you moving away to calmer waters. Or you want to move away to a place of peace together. Or someone is being left behind. We'll break the whole storyline down once we get all the cards in. Yeah, someone walked away. Eight of Cups. Someone walked away from all the emotion, all the time, all the energy, all the effort, all the everything. Someone walked away to find their Nine of Cups. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Ooh, okay. The Six of Swords is clarified by the moon. Maybe someone is leaving someone behind because of some secrets. Or someone is moving away because there was some cheating going on. There's some fear here. Maybe someone's moving out and there's some fear or someone's moving away. Someone could be confused. Okay? Because they want to move away to a place of peace and drop this baggage with the Six of Swords. But there could be some confusion here or some secrets here. This could be involving a marriage, a twin flame connection here. You could be moving into a new home, renovating, painting, redecorating, or this is like a baby shower, a housewarming party, a birthday party, or some type of announcement, maybe a cookout, a family gathering. Or like I said, this is a marriage, a twin flame soulmate connection. 11-11. Why is the moon here? 11-11 also represents manifestation. Why is the moon here? Clarify the moon for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, North Node for April 2021. Oops. Spirit guides, ancestors, angels, universal energies. Clarify the moon for Aries. Clarify the moon. The Ten of Swords, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. This is someone you're dealing with, or this is you feeling betrayed, backstabbed, completely let down. This person probably did this to you more than one time, and you're done. You're done with it. Okay? There's some secrets and some, you know, some betrayal here. Someone could have cheated with the moon showing up here twice, and then the Four of Pentacles. Let me see. Let's see. Let's keep going. Why is the Ten of Wands here for Aries? I'm sorry. I said the Ten of Wands? Oh, my God. I'm so sorry. I am so sorry. The Ten of Swords. Wow. The Ten of Swords is clarified by the Magician. Gemini energy. You have all the tools to manifest anything you want to manifest in your life. Anything that you want to come to fruition. You have the earth element, the water element, the air element, the fire element, and the ethers. You have your wand in your hand. So above. Above, so below. Okay, that's what I was trying to say. Above, so below. So you're trying to manifest. You're trying to send your manifestations into the universe so they can come into fruition. You have all the tools that you need. Okay, eight may be significant to you. Or this is just the infinity symbol. Okay. I feel like you are connected to spirit. Okay. Someone could be having financial issues with the Five of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Or this is someone that is feeling abandoned, neglected, left out in the cold. Somebody probably got put out and is homeless and broke. And just going through it, just struggling, okay? Wow. Why is the Magician here? Clarify the Magician for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Clarify the Magician for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, angels, ancestors, universal energies. Clarify the Magician for Aries. Clarify the Magician. Eight of Cups. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Someone's walking away. This could be like at nighttime, somebody's walking away. Someone's just leaving here. Okay. And they're holding themselves back. Someone that Aries. But yeah, someone, this could be you or someone you're dealing with, holding themselves back from something, restricting themselves from something, taming their lust. Okay, trying to hold themselves back from something. Maybe somebody is walking away, but they're holding back. Why is it Eight of Cups here? Seven of Cups, yeah. Someone like wants to walk away, but there could be like some confusion, or someone has like options. Someone could be like very daydreaming, wishful thinking, or you may have come to realize that this was all an illusion. Maybe this person had multiple partners. That's the Eight of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. You're throwing yourself into your work. You are focused on your money. You're keeping busy. You're mastering your craft. It could be something you're very good at, creative at, DIY projects, construction. Maybe you're a handyman. You love to build something. I see you building like a bed or a chair or some type of bench. All right. But this is you at work keeping yourself busy, keeping focused on your pentacle here, mastering your craft. Why is the Seven of Cups here? Someone with the Seven of Cups and the Devil, they could be like, someone has a lot of options. Maybe this person has an addiction, like to drugs, alcohol, or sex, or eating too much, playing too many games, doing something too much, or this person is obsessed. They want to walk away, but they're confused, or there's some type of illusions, or maybe some options, and this person is obsessing over these options, the sex addiction, or there's some type of lie here. Six of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. This is you, Aries, or someone you're dealing with, standing their ground, putting your foot down. You said what you meant what you said, and that's it. You're not going back on your word. You're not backing down from these people who you feel like are trying to attack you. I feel like you always got to prove yourself to people, stand up for yourself. You always got to prove yourself worth your value to people. People could be gossiping, right? Because this devil energy down here, they could be obsessing over you and talking junk, spreading rumors. Okay, because they're just a toxic ass person with the devil energy right here. Like I said, there's something hidden, not yet known. But there is, your intuition is heightened. Your intuition is heightened. Listen to your intuition this month. Because someone is going to have to make a decision, Aries. This could be you. Having to make a choice to choose a path. Make up your mind. This person needs to make up their mind. Somebody could be indecisive. Or, you know, someone's planning for their future here. You know, there's progress happening. This could be someone from at a distance from you. This person could be in two minds. This is Sagittarius energy. This person needs healing, or this person wants to heal things with you and find some type of balance. Balancing the scales. There's some potential for spiritual growth for you here, Aries. Your third eye chakra is opening. You have peace. Maybe somebody wants to compromise with you. Maybe they make a decision to compromise. Yeah. Ooh. Temperance. You've been patient with yourself. Okay. Maybe this decision, you've been patient with it. Right? So, let's get some additional messages. Oops, sorry. Very sorry. What does Aries want to say to their person? I feel like there was a new path, spiritual journey you were going down. But you probably were keeping it to yourself or saving some money. Because you're really unsure if you wanted to start this new passionate beginning. Someone could have cheated and is not really saying anything about it. Or there's some fear here that there's little to no communication or being left in the dark about some things. Not knowing, not speaking to this person. Somebody may want to reconcile and come in and go take a leap of faith here. Let's see. I can still see you standing there. Okay, so someone, I guess what happened between you and this person, they're replaying this over and over in their mind here. But yeah, with the strength here, you're holding yourself back from going off on somebody maybe. You want to move away to a place of peace. Or maybe you're just holding your energy back from this person because you want to move away. It was some cheating involved here with the moon, and this is a betrayal with the Ten of Swords. And you're manifesting, walking away, exploring other options because this person is a liar. They were in a full-blown relationship somewhere else. They're toxic. I wonder how far this will go. Maybe you wanted to take it the distance with this person. All right, and maybe it just didn't go as far as you wanted it to go in this relationship. I was careless with you. So someone, I feel like someone didn't really give a lot of attention, a lot of, you know, just consistency was off, okay? And at the bottom of the deck, yeah, I never used to look at you in that way. Okay, so this person, whether either you or this person, you could, you know, the energies is vice versa. This could be you or your person and change it around however you want. Whatever resonates, take it, leave the rest. Okay, but this person or you may have looked at someone differently and now... It's like, I never used to look at you in that way. Like, you look at them totally different. Now you have a totally different perspective about this person. And I don't think it's good because that devil energy is down here. Okay, Aries, I really enjoy doing this reading for you. Give me a big thumbs up. Make sure you don't forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for supporting me and getting this reading that you needed today, because I definitely enjoy doing your readings to make sure that you guys get all the clarity that you need. Okay, bye Aries. I'm gonna be doing Cancer reading next. If you want to come and join me, just click the link. Okay, the next link, it'll be playing in the video, the next reading. Bye.